Myanmar's military claims to have found more evidence of voter fraud from November's general election. At the same time, international pressure continues to grow on the army. The G7 has condemned the use of force on protesters, while more sanctions have been imposed on generals.
Saying their final goodbyes, hundreds joined the funeral procession in Mandalay for the 37-year-old man who was shot dead over the weekend. Tet Nai Nguyen was one of the three people killed when security forces opened fire at demonstrators. Protests continue in Yangon a day after millions took the streets in a general strike. While many shops have since reopened, protesters say they want to keep the momentum going despite the army's warning of a crackdown. International pressure is growing on the military government. G7 countries have condemned the army's use of violence against protesters, while the U.S. has sanctioned two more generals, including Myanmar's Air Force chief. But the army is not backing down. It says it's found more evidence of electoral fraud in last November's elections. This includes more than 56,000 extra names on voter lists.
Leong Waikid joins us for more on this. Waikid, a group of lawmakers elected in November is trying to engage with the United Nations. Tell us why.
Well, that's right. Now, these are some of the lawmakers who have been elected back in 2020 during the general election, and they're calling themselves the committee representing the Pidang Suhluto. Pidang Suhluto means Union Parliament in Burmese, and they've basically appointed two people to engage formally with the international community, one of whom is a special envoy to UN. I've reached out to the UN for a response, and it'll be very interesting to see how the UN views this appointment, given that such posts are usually put up by heads of state or governments or foreign affairs of countries. But observers have also pointed out that it's not so much the recognition or the legitimization by the international community. It's also about how these lawmakers want to effectively push out messages to the international community. Now, I also reached out to another Myanmar expert and asked him for his views. Now, he says what's interesting here is that the grouping here has used the 2008 constitution, which is Myanmar's law written by the army, to say that, hey, this part of the law says it's legitimate for us to form this committee. Now, on the other side of the story, we have the Myanmar army, who's also using the same 2008 constitution, citing another part of the law, to say that, hey, we still have the right to seize power. So this gives you a very interesting equation here. We've got two opposing stakeholders with one common factor, the constitution. So this expert says that this gives rise to a potential for both opposing parties to find a common consensus for the country moving forward.
Thanks for that, Leong Waikid, following the developments in Myanmar.